but this amazing flying structured craft has no earthly explanation. It was seen over the small farming village of Kibbutz Hatzor for three consecutive nights in August of 1996. This video, shot by a young resident of the kibbutz, shows a bizarre-looking, partially lit craft with strange red markings and rectangular shapes. When the camera zooms in, we see what appears to be a light on the craft's left side take on amazing structure. The structure, some say, resembles a huge flying building with hallways. 17-year-old Amiche Showa was stunned to be awakened by the strange bright object in the night sky. He watched in amazement as it hovered above for hours. He waited for its return the next night, video camera in hand. By the third night, word of the strange craft had spread, and some 60 members of the kibbutz came out to see it in all its glorious color. This time, Michi's batteries failed, but he managed to film the odd craft again using a neighbor's camera. Look what he managed to capture on tape. The structure is so massive that the illuminated portion is said to represent only 5 to 7% of its actual size. Is this the design of some otherworldly architect? As incredible as it sounds, some UFO researchers claim it could be housing alien inhabitants, giant aliens, as described in the Bible.
No one has ever seen one like this before. So it was captured on two separate nights, one separate morning. Over 100 people saw it.
Barry Chamish is one of the most respected UFO investigators in Israel today. He believes that this is one of the most extraordinary UFOs ever caught on tape.
What we're dealing with Hatzor, is a very large UFO. This thing is not just a round disc. This thing's got windows. It's got two rows of windows or vents or who knows what on earth they're shaped, because they are very odd, offbeat squares. And they managed to get a close-up of these vents. I mean, really close. You're right inside them. And they could be teeth for all you know. And you have no idea what's attacking you. But this orange structure, I believe it's energy vents or something. Something to do with venting energy.
The kibbutz is near an Israeli Air Force base, but Chamish is convinced this is no military craft.
Everything is wrong. The dimensions are wrong. The squares aren't quite squares. If it was a military vehicle, it hasn't come back. It's never been, the likes of it have never been seen ever again.
Then what was hovering above Israel for three consecutive nights that summer?
Obviously, if this is up in the sky, there's nothing that's supposed to be up in the sky that looked quite like that. It apparently is some object which has got that sort of a size to it in this level of blow-up. When they zoom in and get a structured image out of this, it's just plain, it doesn't look like anything that I've ever seen. It doesn't look like any ordinary UFO, that's for sure, but it certainly doesn't look like an airplane or a blimp, balloons or whatever. But this would have to be considered to be